So, you're thinking about repairing your own iPhone. Well, we've got some good news for you and some bad news. The good news is, most common iPhone repairs are pretty easy to do and will only take about an hour. The bad news is, Apple really doesn't want you to fix your own phone, so they put some annoying roadblocks in your way. Here are 5 things you need to know before you repair your own iPhone. First things first, you're locked out, unless you have specialized screwdrivers. Since the iPhone 4, Apple has used tiny proprietary screws called pentalobes to seal your iPhone shut. On top of that, inside most iPhones made in the last few years, you'll find another rare bit, the tri-point. Not only are these screws uncommon, but they're also tiny and extremely easy to strip. Fortunately, if you're buying your replacement screen or battery from iFixit, our kits already have all the drivers you'll need for your repair, and even if you got your part elsewhere, even our most basic driver kits have those drivers you'll need. That brings us to the second thing you'll need to know about repairing your own iPhone. Once you've got your screws removed, your iPhone is still stuck together with adhesive. The iPhone uses adhesive to secure both its screen and battery. The adhesive holding the display down helps with water resistance, and the adhesive on the battery holds it securely in place while the phone is closed. If you're not expecting this adhesive, you can end up slicing or prying too firmly around the sensitive screen, or, far more dangerous, using too much force to lift up the battery. Isopropyl alcohol, or our adhesive remover, can help with stubborn, hard-to-reach glue, like if your battery pull tabs break during removal. But even if you know the adhesive is there, once you remove it, you'll probably want to reapply it, and that can also be tricky. The display adhesive, for example, is extremely thin in places and difficult to place. Fortunately, you don't absolutely have to replace the adhesive once you've removed it from your display. You'll lose the water resistance it provides, but your display won't fly off when you use it. If you want to check out a video showing the process of reapplying the adhesive to retain that water resistance, we've got a video walking you through that process. The third thing you'll want to know is your replacement parts may not work exactly like the original part, even if they're authentic replacement Apple parts. In yet another way Apple has locked down your iPhone, various parts like your screen and battery can be exclusively linked to the logic board on your phone. When you install a new part, your phone may display a warning, or some features may no longer work. A replaced home button can result in Touch ID no longer working, a replaced screen can prevent you from using the True Tone function, and a replacement battery won't allow you to see battery health information. While this sucks, all the errors are for the most part just annoyances, and your phone will work just fine for a long time with the new parts installed. The fourth thing you'll need to know is keeping screws organized during disassembly and reassembly is extremely important. The iPhone uses a variety of extremely small but differently sized screws. It's imperative they go back exactly where they came from. Some models are especially vulnerable to a condition called long screw damage, where longer screws can actually sink down into the logic board, destroying tiny circuits that connect components. Using an organizational tool like our magnetic mat can help keep track of exactly where all the screws came from and make sure they end up reinstalled correctly. And finally, the last thing you need to know about before repairing your own iPhone is activation lock. If you're dealing with a phone that was wiped without turning off activation lock, and you don't have the password of the iCloud account of the last owner, just don't bother. Without that password, the phone is only good for its individual parts. You can spend a lot of time searching around for activation lock workarounds, but none of them really work. Of course, there are other things you should know about iPhone repair, and if you've got questions about a specific repair you're thinking about doing, check out the guides on iFixit.com. Not only do we walk you through the step-by-step process of the repair, but you can find lots of helpful tips and tricks in the comments along the way.